Hello, basketball fans. Great matchup for you tonight between the Wichita State Shockers and the Arizona Wildcats. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
I like the matchup at the small forward position. These two players must lead their team out and show the way. Yes, dictate the way this game is played.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go. And we're off with a tip here in the first half. Gave it up. Number 35 with the fake. In the lane. Nails the J. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when the team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, Brad, you look at your juniors as third-year players who have been there. Nothing should be new to them by the time they're in their third season. They should know what's expected from them in the classroom, and they should know what to expect from their conference opponents. The level of familiarity should be much higher than what it was in their first year.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. Inside, ball down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. On the dribble, gives it up.
Nice high post screen.
Up the foul. First personal foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
Misses the second shot. Gave it up. Sets a screen for his teammate. He tries the three. The missed shot. They work it around the perimeter. For the ball. There's the rejection. On the outside. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, field the defensive player on your hip, going one way, and you spin back the other way.
The perimeter. He shoots from outside. Scores it. He can put points up and he can move the ball.
Hey, when a scorer is able to read and react to pressure like this, holes start showing up in the defense.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Gets it to fall. forward, receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up.
Nice hops. Hey, look out below, baby. Oh, my.
He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper. They work the perimeter. For two. Yikes, misses the easy one. York receives the pass. With the jumper. Nope. Takes the rebound.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
The power forward receives the pass. Fed the low block. He pulls the trigger.
I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
Now trying to feed the low block. The freshman commits a turnover.
Perimeter.
He puts up the J. They're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous?
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
Moving it around the perimeter. Tries for two. He drains the shot. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
For the bucket. The power forward gets the ball. Gave it up. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Top of the circle, they work it around. Blocked. Working it around the perimeter. Arm and foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
Saves it. From downtown. They got it. Out on the wing. Goes up for two. Drains it. On the dribble, gives it up, and a slam. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick and roll situation.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nesta, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Chance to get an easy one here. Cashed it in.
They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Oh, he converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Number 21 receives the pass. They go into the low block. He shoots from the deep corner. He misses the fadeaway. Well, let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
Dumps it in. And the slam.
Up and inside.
Looks at the three. Off the mark. Trying to pack it inside. For two. Off the glass and no good. The point guard with the ball. Looking for a good shot. He looks for three. Jumper won't go. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Can't connect. Tries for two. Trying to feed inside for the bucket. Off the glass and no good.
Look at that spacing.
He tries the jumper. Off the mark. Gave it up. He shoots from the corner and come up short. Number 11 takes the pass.
That's a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Goes in. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
Doing a wonderful job putting the ball on the floor and getting into the painted area.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. The freshman has a brain cramp there and commits a turnover. The center with the ball. They look to get it to the inside. Jumper and score it. Goes up for two. Drains the shot. The power forward with the ball. He tries the fall away. He misses the fadeaway. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They'll work it around the arc with a deep shot from outside. The missed shot. He draws a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Steps
to the line for an easy one. He hits the first shot. Gets two at the charity stripe. Oh, this man's in trouble. Out on the wing. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
He nails the shot. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
Well, he spotted an opening, and he just absolutely great first step, and he exploded to the goal.
On the right side. On the dribble, gives it up for two. It sticks. Good cut, great pass right there.
Great delivery on that back cut. He just hit him at the right time.
Gave it up. Around 8 minutes from it.
Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
The small forward handles the feed. Tries for two. Missed it. With a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Great block shot. We're at the 7 minute mark. For the bucket, he's money with the shot. Inside, goes up, nails a sweet jumper. The Wildcats did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice.
Trying to feed the low block, takes the jumper. He buries the jumper. About 6 minutes remaining on the game clock. He puts up the tray.
Jumper didn't look pretty.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
On the left side. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Bust the J. He went right through that double team.
Hey, let's see if they decide to double next time down. Sort of dumped down inside. Nobody rotated down from up on top.
Missed the jumper. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Number 11 is called for the defensive foul. Third team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. You know, Brad, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them and really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely.
Good. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
makes the third shot. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Down in the low block, trying to work the lane. That was nice. Goes up for two. He drains the bucket. Down inside. He shoots from the corner. Perfectly executed. Gave it up. For two. York picks up the defensive foul. Second personal foul. Bella commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
He'll get the free ones. Makes his first. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Both free throws go. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
They've got him trapped.
Trying to go inside.
Loose ball and bat it in. And we'll head back down to the other end. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
I tell you, he's been awesome. All over the court, making it happen for his team. Let's see if he can keep it up and get the W to go along with his great individual performance. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up with it. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Shoots from outside. And he missed. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Tries for two. Nails the J. On the outside. From the corner. They got it. Minutes left on the game clock. Number 14 with the ball. Takes his jumper. Busts the jumper. He goes up with it.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Number 11 takes the pass. They work it around the perimeter. Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. On the outside, we're at the 2 minute mark. Inside. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. No. On the left side.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
On the left side. Puts up the tray. And score it. Now they work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Not there. Cross court. And it's heading out of bounds. No, great save. Baker saves it and come up short.
He wants it.
He's asking for it on the low block, and they don't get it to him. Scorches the net with a J. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Puts up the J. Bust the J. He had to hurry that one. Missed the jumper. At halftime, the Shockers are ahead by 16. Wichita State is showing some deadly accuracy from the field in the first half.
Hey, for sure, Brad. This kind of accuracy can easily be carried over to the second half if they continue to be patient with the lock. Patience and poise usually equals points.
Comes back in.
You know, let's hope he didn't get too ice cold out there sitting on that pine. Sometimes you get to be a little frigid.
They work the perimeter. Shoots. Comes up short. York handles the feed. Working around the perimeter. For two, tickles a twine. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to. Clock shot usually creates momentum.
He gets the rejection. He drains it. Goes out of bounds, and we'll stay at this end.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
Out on the wing. And the jam. Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up with a shot. They get it to go. Fed the low block. Puts up the shot. Perfectly executed. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
Now trying to feed the low block. He pulls up with a jumper. The missed shot. Anderson receives the ball. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on a defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
They go into the low block. Blocks it. He rejects it.
Poor job on the offensive end. Great job defensively rotating to the basketball.
Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
And two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works.
Did a great job of getting to the hoop on that one, Richard.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
Number 11 looks to be down emotionally.
Brad, I see a young man who's struggling at both ends of the court.
Number 35 with the foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all. Here's the trap.
York comes up with it. Working it around the perimeter. There is no play that includes that guy in the stands. On the inbounds play. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. That kid's making him think about every shot, Dick.
And he's doing it without fouling, which is the key.
Number 23 gets the ball. Controlling the ball. The senior commits a turnover. For two, he gets it to fall. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
I tell you what, they get an A for effort in my book so far, Brad. Sometimes that's the hardest thing to get from your team as a coach. When you have everyone on your team working together and playing hard, great things work out.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. With a jumper, scores it. Anderson receives the ball. He fades away. Nails the fadeaway.
Up and inside.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Looking for a good shot. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Look at that spacing.
From three-point territory. Missed it. He gets it to go. Dumps it in. Bad decision there by the freshman. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Gets a hand in the way. Gave it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Off the mark. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that. if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Number 23 receives the pass. Trying to pack it inside. Jumper nails a sweet jumper. They'll work it around the arc. Tries for two. He gets the shot to fall. Baker receives the ball. He puts up the J and come up short. You can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
They've got him right where they want him. That poor judgment results in a backcourt violation.
You got to take care of the rock, baby.
The shooting guard handles the pass. For the bucket, bust the J.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Goes up and score it. Looking for a good shot. With the J. Nope. The small forward receives the ball. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Takes his jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
On the dribble, gives it up. Puts up the jet. The shot drops and the foul.
Great concentration on the shot, Brad.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the line. Gets it. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day. He's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. Makes the shot.
Double team now, bad angle.
Gave it up. For two, knocks it down.
The D has no energy left on offense.
Their life is being sucked out of them right now in the defensive end. Way out on top, controlling the ball. He tries the jumper, gets the J to fall. The dribble, gives it up. He attempts the jump shot. Jumper won't go. Way out on top, controlling the ball, knocks it down.
uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc looking for the open jumper.
Silly mistake.
On the outside. And now the fadeaway jumper. Can't connect. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Oh, yes. Good find on that back cut, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, when you can mix teamwork and execution, you get plays like that, Mr. Nestler.
Trying to feed inside. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around and fade away. Missed it. 8 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside.
Turnover by the freshman. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. The Wildcats might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. I think it's time to ditch any default strategy in hopes of getting some quick baskets and some easy scores.
Hey, Brad, they have to increase the tempo and start pressing. Basically, do the things they aren't used to doing. Their backs are against the wall.
Out on the left wing. Takes the medium-range jumper. They got it. They look to get it to the inside. 7 minutes left on the game clock for the bucket. Sinks it.
I'll tell you, Brad, what a breakdown defensively.
They work it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He goes up with it. He misses the jumper. They work the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. He nails the shot. Baker receives the ball. 6 minutes left in the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. He misses the J. The center with the ball. Dumps it in. Goes up with it. Off the mark. Gave it up. For the bucket. Off the glass. An absolute stranglehold by the defense so far tonight.
Hey, the other team is responding by throwing up quick shots, which is exactly what the defense wants. Dumped down inside. Nobody rotated down from up on top.
About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Tries for two. Off the backboard. On the dribble, gives it up. Lobs it. Goes up. Off the mark. Gave it up. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Missed the jumper. York receives the pass. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
Minutes left on the game clock. He gets the shot to fall. He tries the jumper. Nope. For the deuce. The layup is good. A little two-man action. Goes up for two. Was that beautiful or what? Dumps it in. Puts it on the floor and up and under. And come up short. The shooting guard gets the ball. The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Gets the rejection. About 3 minutes remaining. York receives the ball. Takes the three-pointer. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
In the post. He gets the bucket to drop and gets the foul.
He felt the pressure on the way up, but managed to keep himself focused on the rim.
Three goes to the line, shooting one. Makes the foul shot. Moving it around the perimeter. For two, he gets the bucket. Working it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. We're at the 2 minute mark. Unloads a three. Knocks it down.
It's a 2-point game. The fans are going to make it even tougher, Brad.
You didn't expect him to quiet down, did you, Dick? There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best. Up and inside.
For the bucket. Lays it up. Wow, what a finish on that back cut.
I tell you, that was a great backdoor play. Terrific execution right there. Defense stopped concentrating for a second, and they got beat back door.
In the post. He puts up the J and score it. He shoots the jumper, scores it. Looking for a good shot. The turn to fadeaway jumper. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
That's basic.
Tries for two. How do they respond here, Dick?
Well, quick baskets, quicker fouls, Brad. No in between.
And they burn a timeout here. We'll have more NCAA coverage coming up in a moment. Timeout's been called, so let's check in with Aaron.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Well, that was certainly a lot to take in on the sidelines.
Hey, that's a coach who knows what he wants from his team. He understands what they are capable of, and he doesn't want to see them slip and play below their level.
They switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
Shot clock is dead. Into their zone motion now. Cross court. Up with the shot.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Foul, and that stops the clock again. The lead is down to a bucket.
Hey, this place is about to explode. It's dynamite, baby.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. That makes it a two-point game, Dick.
And the Palms are starting to sweat, believe me.
York steps to the line for the first time. Foul shot, no good. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. Into their zone motion now. With the J. Arizona was caught in quite a battle tonight before pulling ahead for good.
They expected to beat a victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.